Okay, we are. I'm talking. We are gonna do computer audio. Instead of the AirPods again, so I'm assuming you're like. If you can at any point, let me know either in the chat or raise your hand or do something to let me know. We'll test it out during warm up. I'll be sure to watch if you can't hear me. Okay, we are using. We're using light and heavy weights. I also have a mat set up, so if you want to get your space set up, we will be starting in like a couple minutes. Okay.
How you feel? Good. Yay. Okay. We are doing 30 because that's what I'm doing. Total body.
And now we wait. Has anyone taken or watched one of the recorded classes before? No. I watched myself on the recording because they upload them to YouTube sometimes. It's really weird. It's super weird. I don't know if anyone's done a YouTube workout, but it looks completely, like, feels completely different than just the professionalism of, like, the YouTube fitness people. Kind of makes me want to do it, though. Just a little. Also, if you're aware, you can be seen in the mirror from this camera, but you can't be seen in the mirror. And I can move it if you don't. I'm just waiting for Zoom people. And our time, I guess. How do we feel about it? Excited for week 9?
Excited for week 9?
I'm excited to be done. Okay, Zoom peeps, we have our space set up with heavy weights, light weights, a mat, maybe a towel, maybe some water, maybe you get a playlist going. I think you'll be able to hear my playlist this time because I can't use the AirPods, they're just not connecting. I'm using the microphone and the speaker audio. If that is having issues, I need to speak up, I need to come closer, put it in the chat, raise your hand, let me know. We'll test it during. Okay, we're probably good enough.
Is everybody ready to start? Okay, so I'm Maddie. This is Strength in Town. Welcome. I'm so glad to have you here. It always feels good to see smiley faces back at you when you're here. So we have 2 segments today. We're using a pair of heavy weights, mostly for legs, light weights for arms. We're going to be doing all the work in both circuits, so I'm not like taking up my body type or body part or anything. I guess we'll just get started with a warm up. We pull up my timer, you will be hearing the beeps. Sometimes I don't actually completely follow the beeps, but it's always helpful to have. So you want to stand up with me. We're going to start in a march. So pull it back, take a deep breath. Setting yourself, are you ready to work today? So you start thinking of an intention, how you want to make this movement purposeful, strength building for you and your body today. So we'll start the march. Right here, picking up our feet, moving our arms. We're gonna stay in this march through this feet. Just taking some more deep breaths. So, sometimes I feel like we're not silly, but it's really important that we get our heart rate up, our body hard before we start in all the work. So, bear with me, feels very long fast, we're gonna do it. In 4, 3, march out, out, in, mid, out, out, in, mid, have a V step. We're gonna already take it down to the corner of the squat. I just want to wake up those quads. Not thinking about as much. In 4, 3, step past the streets. We're gonna go overhead first, extending that side body. See if you can get across your center body. So across, and that activates the inner core. Open your back, your chest. Feels so good. We're going to keep the legs and the arms in 4. Bring it to a twist. So twist and twist. One side and the other. Really deep breath. Turning both shoulders completely awesome. We're going to do those 4 moves again, starting with the march. In 4, 3, arch it out. Right here. Okay, now you can add your own layer if you want to. And just our jump again. In four. Butterfly. And out, out. In four, three, step top to the full reach. Step, reach, and reach. Awesome, having a little more purpose. So you're moving here, being intentional, waking up your body. In four, three, arms across your body. Reach, and reach. We're thinking about extending palm, reach, reach. Feels so good to my upper lab. Okay, we're gonna switch. We're gonna go to a double knee lift. In four, three, get to the double knee lift. Lift, 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 switch, switch. So we have new four moves, a little bit more intense. Learn to do some and then you'll get a chance to perfect. In four, three, bring it down to some more street curl. Hips curl and curl. So just one heel up to the seat on time. And now the chest over. In four, three, step hips to the front. Step hips and from my guard up, my core strong. Hips in line with my shoulders. And then you draw from the knee up to that next step. Gradually getting a little bit higher. Awesome. In four, three, bring it back for a heel. Six, and six. Pressing one heel into the floor. Kind of those arms hanging, your shoulder work here. Okay, now we're gonna go back from double knee lifts. This time I want you to think about activating the core, drawing the knee to your chest. Four, three, back to double knee lifts. Lift, lift, switch, switch. Awesome, good job. A little bit more energy behind me. Great. You can do those arms, you can move a little higher. Cool, cool. Okay. In four, three, bring it down to a constant curl. It's curl and curl. You're ready to try for you to curl up. Curl up. A little more energy there. In four, three, back to the front. Kick, and kick, kick. Awesome. Get a little bit easier as your muscles are warming up to get your legs a little bit higher. Again, leading with the knee, out with the toes, just on a swing. Three, two, down with the legs. Heels into the floor. Awesome. Okay, then we're gonna move on to the last level. Uneven jumping. Unequipped knee to walk through or step through any moves. Do it. In four, three, dog it out. So at this point, maybe you're starting to be in your body, starting to get a little breathless. If you're not there yet, we do have energy to move arms to get that area. In four, three, aim up, high knees. I always tell people, walk through your high knees. That's great, just as effective. And just pull it over. In four, three, bring it out to the ladder on top. And top, and up. So from side to side, making sure you're landing on the ball of your foot. As you can get it, you can get a little lower. As you're coming in that spot the whole time, or you're trying to find your distance, or however you want to challenge yourself. In four, three. Jump rope, place. Jump rope. Three, four, three, six, go down. Last move of this round, we're going to do it once more. Nice and long. Awesome.
Center chest,
you skate it up to your last 20 seconds. Yeah.
Feels on your
Side box for 30 seconds. 15 seconds.
Step back,
since you come out to you, I just come out, when we go forward, if I am, I get 90 degrees both legs. 50 more seconds. Slow for eight. Three, two, and one. Leg the squat on, legs down. We're gonna go toes, knees, toes, jump. Four, three, two, and one. Toes, knees, toes, jump. Again, if you're not a jumper, come up just to the heel raise. That's great. You want to challenge yourself with the dumbbells. Think about pointing your toes as you jump. Get you higher, also activate good back for legs. Ten seconds. And one, awesome. Okay. Down to the mat. We're gonna do single leg crunches. We're gonna isolate. We'll pause this so I can feel better. Isolate each side. The first one, you're gonna swing your right side. Second hand, let's go. If we're not all okay, just stick with one side, and see what goes back. So with your arms long, your legs long. You're gonna take your right hand, bring it up, kind of come into a curl, touch the toe, bring it back down. It's called a down high sit up. So you're rolling up to sit up, and then you're lifting that leg. If you would rather, have your feet down planted, and then just go to a march like that, so you're not, you have the full lever of your straight leg. That's a great option. Ready? Have you prepared? Here we go, on four, three, two, and one. Right arm, left leg. That's all we're moving this side, this round. You try to reach them in the center. Nice and controlled all the way down. Awesome. Like one vertebra at a time. So pulling. Controlled. See if you can lift everything at the same time. Arm lifts, leg lifts all at once. That'll be a challenge. Awesome. You're flexing your foot for more core activation. Awesome. Six seconds. Three, two, and one. Laying it back down. Just stretch for a second on the ground. We're just gonna switch the opposite side, do the exact same thing. One hand to the opposite toe and center. Jump next set. Three, two, and one. You might find that one side is easier than the other. That's normal, that's how you're separating, so you can strengthen both sides and the legs. Halfway, your core might be starting to get a little tired now, but you're doing the same type of movement. Second in on it, push through, you can do it. Nice and control, trying to lift the arms and the leg into your own. 8, 7, 6, 3, 2, 1. All right, oops, sorry. We're staying on the mat, flip it over, see if it's short. All right, you've done this before, so you know them. You're gonna put your hands, shoulders, distance apart, holding directly over the hands, so bring on your knees, on your toes. From that plank position, bend the elbows. See how you can do in this workout. Here we go. Also, elbows can go wide, they can go 45 degrees. We can draw them nice and close to your chest for more tricep work. Finding different to which one you choose. Which one is comfortable for you. Take hours. Three more seconds. At any point, you want to switch from knees to toes, you want to switch where your hands, where your elbows are going. And rotate through some things. We're just making sure we're holding on to that plank bar before you engage full time. And trying to work some arms. 5 seconds. You do 3 more. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Awesome. Okay, let's grab some light weights. Come up to standing. You have 2 arms. We're going to start with bicep curls. Elbows pinned to your side. Palms facing out. Just going to curl in and down. Here we go. Up and down. Okay. Personally, I'm already bored. So we're going to go straight up and then out. So it's your normal bicep curl. And you go out this leg. You want to stick to the regular bicep curl. Leg comes a little back. 20 more seconds. If you have your, or tightening through your core, your knees are bent, have better stance. So that's the beginning. 7 seconds. Push ups and bicep curls. Another deal. 2 and 1 with some rest. We're going to go bent over or tricep kickback. So just like you're doing a chest side, the chest is going to face the ground. You're going to row, elbows raising your ribcage up. Extend the arms out, back to a bend, and down. Here we go. Elbows up, extend out, back to a bend, and down. Nice and controlled. So, really thinking about fully lengthening through the arm and locking out that elbow. That's our hip and tricep work. So 20 more seconds. Then we go back to the top of the circuit. Make sure your shoulders aren't creeping up to your elbows and roll them back. Anyway, your ears. Roll them back and down. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Weights down. We have Superman with one pull back. Turn back. Down on your mat, lying down. Arms and legs out long. We go 4, 3, 2, 1. Keep lifts up. Super clean long. Forward and backward. Then you've got it. You can take your hands down to that. So you're pulling down, not coming to the back. You are squeezing the shoulder blades, try to make the elbows touch behind the knees. If you want more of a challenge, you can either try to bring your heels together or the booty. 15 seconds. And you can do it. Say hi, lift up another inch. 10, 5, 4, 3. Two. And one, offset. So lower. Push yourself up. Booty rockers. Lunges. We're going to grab our heavy weights. Alternating reverse lunges. Starting with feet from a distance. Try to have other stairs. Here we go. 3, 2, and 1. So back to my feet. We're going to lift the legs. Nice and controlled movement. So you can get a little bit lower to where your knee, acne is just covering a couple inches under the floor. Awesome. What do you think about any of that acne? You can also frame this move as if it were a squat. So for that front leg, squat, and just have a hip stand behind you. Anyway, if you have it, I thought that helped me actually get it personally. 3, 2, and 1, weights down. We have the squat jumps. Toes, knees, toes, jump. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Here we go. Toes, knees, toes, jump. Move through this speed up. You're ready to go faster than I am. You are looking to. Standing nice and soft, and the knees bent. Touching the knees. 20 more seconds. And then our heart rate is tight. Back up. Those. 10 seconds, you can do it. How many more jumps can you get?
So,
really squeezing those triceps at the top there. So how high can you get those buttocks, arms? Right. Four, three, two, and long knees down. Okay, so that was the end of our circuit. But hip and the arm. And four, and you're out. So that really fast, so we're not hurt. Feel free to take your plank. I love it. Feel free to take your plank down on your elbows or in high plank on your hands. Make sure you're point of contact with the ground. Your shoulders are directly over, whether that's your elbows or your hands. I want you to shift it forward. You're also welcome to take this plank on your knees or your toes. One knee at a time. I don't know. See if you have a minute plank. That is a challenge. Go for as long as you can. Come down, take a breath. Come back, back. Okay? All I want. All right, are you ready? Here we go. Minute plank. Find your best plank form. The belly plank. Into and one. If you're on your elbows, try to keep your hands parallel to each other, your forearms parallel, or separated at the top. Great. Another way to challenge yourself is flipping those palms up. Awesome. If one of the plank forms gets uncomfy, you want to switch? That's good. You'll come. Elbows to hands. You can do that. 30 more seconds, arch halfway. Hang on to it. Make sure those hips stay low. Eight. Think about squeezing the glutes. Okay. All about it. 15 seconds. Your best lengths are 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. And one, nice. Okay, now we're turning a little timer to set activity completed. We did it. Let's switch to a stretching playlist. When you come on your back, we are going to stretch. Okay. That was a good workout. Great job, everybody. So if your arms and legs are long, you're lying on your back. Yeah. Taking some deep breaths. Think about your water or your towel close by. Heart rate come back down. Your arms maybe up long above your head, letting that lower back arch again, letting it come off the mat. A couple more deep breaths. Feeling grateful for your body and what you put in today. Noticing how strong you are, how strong you've been. One more deep breath. Let's draw your knees into the chest. Next, we squeeze. Sending the left leg onto the floor, the right leg onto the ceiling, and reverse the ankle circles. Switch directions. Moving your flex and toes. Sending that right ankle across onto the left knee, bend your arms through, and reverse stretch. Bring it back for center once more. Both feet both knees in the chest on the final time. Rock yourself side to side, massage, back. And then rock yourself into a seated position. We're gonna start right here. Cross legged and wherever you like to sit. One arm across the chest. Gentle pull. Either above or below. Gently switch. Gently release. Spring up to standing. Take your time as you get up on the floor for a bit. When you're ready, drawing one heel into your seat. And stretch. Great rest of your Wednesday. Maybe if you can, grab the salary.